In rural Mali, the war has thrust community health agents to the forefront.
When the war came, I was very scared. We began having roadblocks. People said they were manned by foreign troops who did not understand French, but I carried on. I changed my routine, but I never stopped working.
9-month-old Kadia has diarrhea and a fever. Mariam Samabali gives her rehydration salts and zinc. She gives health tips to her mother. Community health agents are in the front line of the fight against diarrhea, malaria and pneumonia, the biggest killers of under fives. The agents' role was enhanced when rebels targeted government buildings.
When, in certain localities, health infrastructure was no longer functioning, people still were within reach of an agent who could treat simple cases of childhood illnesses. The agents had medication and they continued to do their jobs in the communities where they had remained.
In Baima, malaria is the big challenge. Just a day after 7-month-old Mariam began treatment, her fever's come down. But at the height of fighting in April 2012, Baima was cut off. Sumaila Koulibaly feared being mistaken for an Islamist insurgent. He couldn't travel to replenish his stocks of generic drugs.
I have changed my way of working and my behavior. I have changed my way of dressing too. We heard it was best not to have a beard, to avoid wearing a jalaba. So now I wear youth clothes, like jeans. I feel good here. I am sure that if something happened in this village, the villagers would protect me. They would, I am sure.
As war takes its toll on Mali's health system, under a parapet in Baima, a child's life may quietly have been saved. Alex Duval-Smith reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org.